Welcome back to the workshop. We're going to be taking a look at a project I thought up when I saw this model being released online and I picked it up. I thought this is something that I can show you guys that'll be cool for those of us that like RC stuff, radio control stuff, and those that like hard plastic styrene scale models and weathering. It's like two in one. It's the best of both worlds because it's going to be a scale model of a sweet square body Chevy K10 that we can also drive and enjoy. And I've got a cool accessory to go with it. So it's not just going to be this, it's going to be something else we're going to see in a second. But this is FMS 1/18th scale, which is the same size as die cast models. So if you really wanted to, you could try to find a way to import one of those steel bodies onto this RC chassis. But let's take a look. I picked up this kit online. You can usually source these things on sale. If you wait for stuff to go on sale and discount codes and stuff, you should be able to pay about $105 for it. About $150, $160, you can get it. It is completely ready to run. It has everything you need. So unlike a lot of other RC stuff, you won't have to buy it and then go buy batteries and radios and all this other kind of stuff for it. It's all in this little box here. It's a styrene carrying case. And that's kind of cool. On the inside, looks like we've got the radio. It is a full function proportional model. Nice little pistol grip radio. Looks like it's got some, oh yeah, it's got some settings in here that you can check, your throttle trims and all that stuff. So that's all in there. That's RC stuff. I'm not really going to go over that. I'm not reviewing this kit in particular. I'm just going to be using this and show you how to weather and stuff and enjoy it. But it's got a nice foam grip. The steering and throttle will be completely variable. So unlike the stuff you find at Walmart, when you turn the wheel a little bit, the tires on the model will turn a little bit. You don't get lock to lock every time. And the throttle and reverse are completely proportional as well. So you don't have to worry. You can drive it slow, you can drive it fast, whatever you want to do with it. So that little radio comes with the kit in the box. Normally, a lot of times with RC stuff, you have to buy that extra. This, wow. Take that out. Oh, that is nice and shiny. Woo. Look at the gloss on that. Boy, if you wanted a really sharp looking 18th scale model, that paint job looks nice. We got a folding tailgate with nice metal hinges. Okay, we'll take a, let me open that up. I think I just lift it out there. Oh, okay. Hold on. There's more stuff in the box. Then we'll look at the truck. In the box as well is a little wrench for taking the wheels off and a battery charger that plugs into a USB port. So let's open that up quick. This is ubiquitous to most RC models as you get a little T-wrench like this. This is for popping off wheel nuts and doing any other adjustments that they allows you to do. Those are handy. Keep those handy. They're really nice. And it looks like a USB charger. So any USB outlet will charge the mini battery that comes with the vehicle. Let's get some stuff out here. Wow. This is just, that is impressive. That's as good looking as any expensive die-cast car I've ever seen. Now, we know nowadays, right now, a really nice die-cast car will run you over $100, and for just like $40-$50 more, you get one that looks like this and is full RC and has lights. It's going to have headlights that light up. We've got turn signals. I don't know if the turn signals light up or work, but they are there, and I can see holes behind them for a light. We got that gorgeous bow tie on there. It's officially licensed. Let's look at the back here. We got a tailgate. Oh, the tailgate does open. Oh, and it does snap shut. Yeah, it says Chevrolet like it should. It's got that nice diamond plate step. We got the squared off turn signals on the back. A really nice two-tone paint job. My grandpa owned one like this, but it was yellow and black. That mustard yellow with the black stripe, he had that, and it had a black roof on it. I'm not going to be repainting the main colors, but we are going to be getting paint on this. It has a full interior. I don't know if you can see that. It's got the Chevy steering wheel, the dashboard. It's got windshield wipers. Oh, and they move. Sweet. It's got mirrors. I don't think the mirrors move. Door handles. It's got lugs for the bed stakes. So you could fill those in with black if you wanted them to look more realistic. It's got a full length bed. It is a long box and it's a full depth too. Underneath, ooh, I love these. We got a full aluminum chassis. So these rails are aluminum. We've got trailing links and coilover shocks, which a real one would have leaf springs in the back. We've got solid axle in the front with links and steering. We got a little mini steering servo. We've got squishy, squishy off-road tires. Are they discarded? Oh, they're actually Cooper tires. Look, they actually say Cooper Discoverer STTs, the STT Pro tire. It's a scale tire with those nice lug wheels, those bullet hole wheels, or revolver wheels. This thing is really sharp. And then the radio equipment and all that is supposed to be under the hood. And you can see the suspension is full working. It's a soft suspension because this is supposed to be a rock crawler. So we get really nice articulation and stuff like that. It's not supposed to be a bone stock Chevy CK. Okay, and there we go. The hood opens. Has a little plastic protector on it, I suppose, for when they sit at hobby shops and every schmuck comes in and plays with it. So we'll get that out of the way. Otherwise, the paint's not going to stick. Okay, we got an on and off switch. We've got a circuit board in here. We've got the little 7.4 volt battery, balance charger, and the power plug. We got the power plug to plug it in. Clearly, that is not waterproof. You can see the open electronics, so I would not submerge this truck. But we'll put the battery on the side, we'll get that charged. The charging the battery is as easy on these modern RCs as you plug in. It's directional, you can't screw it up. You plug in the charge connector, you stick that in the USB, you look for the LED light, when it goes solid, you're done. So that's as easy as charging the battery is on those. We'll close that hood. And that snaps down securely. So what I'm going to do is, I see a bunch of screws underneath here. I am going to attempt to take the body off so I can work on it a little easier. Otherwise, we're going to have to mask the glass and stuff so I can spray dull coat and whatnot. But I'm guessing the body comes off. I see some screws down here on the side of the bed. I see more there. So we do have screws on there. I'm going to see if I can get that body off, and I'll be right back. While I'm attempting to get the body off, while I'm figuring that out, going online, seeing if other people have pulled it off and stuff like that, which if it's not, it's not a big deal. I can mask off the glass and work on the outside stuff, take the wheels off and stuff, and I can work on that. I also picked up from hobbyburger.com their camper set. For this pickup, it's designed, it's 3D printed, it's a mom and pop operation. I will put a link in the description where you can snag one of yours from them. And so I got this, and I want to put it in the back of the pickup truck when we're all done, because that's what my grandpa's truck looked like. And I'm just trying to fit it by hand here. It's a tight fit. We'll get it on there. But what... It also, you can order separately. If you just want the camper, you can order the camper. It comes with the optional air conditioning unit, which goes up here. Grandpa never had air conditioning unit on his. So that I'm not going to be using, but it is available to you. And a bed that will go up underneath here so they could sleep at night. I'm going to just use plexiglass to cover that, so it looks like his just had a vent window up there. But you can also order a separate piece, doesn't come with the camper, the full interior, which is 3D printed as well. You got a refrigerator, freezer, microwave, oven, four burner stove, got a sink with faucet, we've got cabinets, we've got a table, we've got storage, and even a little ladder to get up to the top. Now, this is 3D printed. You can see it's filament printed. So if you want to smooth this stuff down, you can work on it. But this comes as one large chunk, so getting in here and painting is going to be kind of a bear. But we'll figure it out. I'll figure out how to do it. I got to get this in primer, and then we'll be hand painting it. I've got to get this in primer, and then I want to stripe it like Grandpa's was. Two of these lines here, since they're so prominent, will be easy to mask, and put a color stripe down the side to match the truck, how you used to be able to order them like that. So you could do a stripe up top, down low, a couple stripes, you could do whatever you want. But this is a cool looking accessory. You got the door on the back. It is filament printed, so there is a little bit of roughness on it. You might have some stuff you want to fill on it. The top is smooth as glass. The front's got a little bit of steps to it and stuff like that. You can fill that in with Mod Podge, if you didn't know that, if it really made a big deal to you. But for me, I just want to make it look nice. And these sides were always corrugated anyways. There is no clear plastic included. If you want to add windows to the inside, simply cut some clear styrene or any clear plastic that comes with your packaging, any clear plastic that comes with a new shirt around the collar, and glue that in on the inside and do any cleanup that you want to do. But hobbyburger.com has these available for the FMS trucks. The bed for it goes up in like that. So if you want the bed that you can see through the windows, you can put that in there. That will just sit right on top, like so. And you can attach it with glue or cement or however you want to put it on there. That thing looks pretty cool. Looks a lot more like Grandpa's truck now. Got it all locked in. We'll get that fit better when we start doing final fitments and whatnot, if I have to shave anything. And that will go on there. So then you have a really cool looking camper on the back of your CK, four-wheel drive, off-road truck. You have an interior that will, once I clean it up a little better, looks like some of the printing is a little wide on it. But that's going to go down inside. Yeah, looks like we're going to have to shave off this edge from the printing. Some of these little nibs on the side, that can easily be sanded off. That will go down inside, and then the camper will drop right over the top of it. We got a lot of work to do. I'm going to work on getting this body off if I can. If I can't, the next thing we'll do is we'll start masking off stuff so we can start spraying dull coat on it. Take the wheels off. We can weather the chassis up, and we'll start working on things on the way back. Okay, after a lot of unscrewing, which is something you can't do to a pregnant woman, we've got it all set up. Now, I was not able to remove the glass. You can remove the glass, but what ended up after I removed the chassis and the interior and the inner fender liner with the on-off switch, all these little components just unplug from the electronics under the hood, same as the motor and the steering servo. They've all got directional plugs, so you can't make a mistake. They all just go back into their ports when you're all done. So I've got that all taken apart. That's a really cool looking chassis. Aluminum frame rails, got plastic connectors. It's got these cool differentials. They are all spools. There is no actual differential action going on in there. These universal joints coming down from the transfer case with the little 380 motor on it, the little 9-gram servo to the steering arm. It's a really cool setup. These are friction shocks. There's no oil in them. They do sell oil shocks. There's all kind of modifications you can do for the RC end of your model if you decide to do that. But what we're going to do is concentrate on the body and stuff. I've got the interior pulled out. We got that nice bench seat and the dashboard. The dashboard's got gauges in it. There are decals in there, so you make sure you cover those up because I want to repaint the interior. I like more of that tan interior on the GM, so that's what I'm going to be doing with that, and we'll be detailing that as well. Got the mask around all the glass, and I masked off the lights, the markers, and the headlights. Headlights are kind of difficult to mask on this one. You know what a great tip is that Chris will give you along the way here today? Is Silly Putty. Works great for masking off items because it conforms to them. The only thing is, Silly Putty is a type of liquid, so if you mask off these headlights and walk away for a week, it will ooze and pull down, and you just have to peel it off and push it back in. But if you're going to be painting within the next hour or so, Silly Putty is amazing. I haven't noticed it ever leaving any residue, and you can see I paint with it all the time. It takes in the paint and all that stuff, but that's what I use it for. We've got the taillights painted. Now, what I'm going to be doing next is applying a flat coat to dull down this paint finish, and then trying, I will be coming back and masking off the white so I can start to fade the red. So I don't have to do as much by hand. I can do it with sprays. The reason I didn't take the glass out was, Once I got the dashboard out, I'd have to take the hood hinges off, and I've got the hood and the electronics glued into place underneath so they stay there. There's two little screws for the glass there, but then there's these very large clips on the side that you have to try to squeeze out and press out, and then you've got the screws that hold these little tiny mirrors on. And I said, you know what, I just took some masking tape, masked off the glass from the outside, and that'll be more than good enough for this build. We've got it apart enough that I can flip and roll and work on this and everything while I'm doing it, and I've got the interior out so that I can work on that. I've got the bumpers off so I can work on those and get some rusting going on that chrome, some pitting, and that's what we're going to do now. We're going to head over to the paint booth. We're going to do some finals. We're going to do some spraying on that. I'm going to get primer coats on the camper. I'm going to get primer coats on the interior. We're going to mask the camper so I can add my stripe. I'm going to decide where I want to put it, and then I'm going to mask that off, and then we're going to start to work on the vehicle itself and get it weathered up. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Once I have all that work into it, it's just painting. We didn't really have to build anything on this review. I picked up the FMS. I got the camper and the interior from hobbyburger.com. It's a small source guy. The Chevy trucks are available at different RC outlets, wherever you want to buy it from. They make a Toyota, they make an FJ. I really like it, so I may end up picking up both the FJ since I had one, and maybe we'll do a video on repainting that FJ from the yellow it comes in or whatever it comes in to the blue that I owned one, and having a replica of my FJ that I can drive around. But this one I had to get. I had to get the Chevy first because my grandpa had one, and he had a two-tone one like this. It just wasn't red. And I wanted to kind of beat it up and weather it up. And he had a camper on the back of his, and his had a matching black stripe for his black and yellow one. I did a red stripe to match it. I didn't fade that red because the campers always stay in better shape than the truck steel. The corrugated metal they're made out of is usually like aluminum or a galvanized metal, so they don't usually rust very easily until they get super old. Plus, they're not exposed to the road. So what I did was I just dusted the camper itself and dirtied it up. Now, I don't have a motorized turntable strong enough to spin this like my models, but you could check this thing out. We could put some decals back here, some bumper stickers. We could set it all up and make it look really awesome. We got it all painted in for the vents and then the reflectors on the side. We got the body rusted out. I didn't crust it out. I just faded that red, that GM red, faded almost instantly if left outdoors. So we showed you how to fade the paint. I rusted the bumpers and the exposed metal on the outside. We put that seat cover on there because my grandpa had those Silverado seat covers that look like kind of like a Mexican poncho. Do you remember how popular those were in the 80s? So I had some old fabric laying around. I always pick up pieces of fabric at like Hobby Lobby in the clearance aisle. They'll have leftover fabric, and that looks very 70s, early 80s. So I glued it to the seat, which is what he had. I did the tan dashboard so that when we look in through the windows, and I'll have pictures of it, we can see much more of those nice gauge packages. He had that aluminum applique over the top of the plastic. He didn't have the wood grain on his because he had always had the fancier model with the power windows and the 350 and the four-wheel drive and the optional differentials. He always had the heavy-duty packages on his, so that's what I went with, was the fancier Silverado Classic or whatever, Sierra Classic they called it, for the interior. And then he had his camper on, and he absolutely beat the hell out of his truck. He actually worked with it. He's the kind of old guy that could go into the woods with a bald set of tires, never put it in four-wheel drive, and never get stuck. And the kid that comes in with a jacked up 2500 HD on mud tires in an 8-inch lift gets stuck in four-wheel drive with the diffs locked 4 feet in. Grandpa was just that kind of a guy. So I really enjoyed weathering and beating this up. I did the frame. I didn't do the underbody of the body, that black area, because we never see it again. But we can see the frame. We can see the differentials from the outside. So I did rust those and weather those as I showed you. And then we did everything else. The vehicle's got some cool features on it. But first, I'll show you the inside of the camper. I cut the lugs off the bottom of the camper so that it fit on top of the camper shell, because I have the interior. If you are just going to buy the camper shell itself, don't cut the lugs off that fit it on the box, but so that I can easily take it off. It fits nice and tight right around that interior, and the interior fits extremely tight into the box, so it's not going to fall out. I mean, you can pick the model up by it. It's not going to come out, and it doesn't glue in, so you can still yank it out if you want to weather the box. And hobbyburger.com has a whole bunch of other interior accessories for this box, like a tow bed and a utility rack for ladders and stuff. It's really cool. But I did a quick and easy paint job on the interior. It could have got much more detailed, but I just wanted to slap that out in a couple hours and get it painted up. That looks awesome inside of there. Did a rubberized floor, got the ladder up to the interior area. We've got the bed we have to glue in place, and then we've got the camper. You can see through the windows of the camper to see the interior enough, and you can see inside the interior of the truck, so you might want to detail those out better than I did. Now let's look at some features of this RC model, because we can now drive this thing and screw around and drive it around. And we'll see how nice that goes on. That just locks right on there. Makes the spring squat a little bit. We'll bring the camera down. It's got some cool features that you can control from the transmitter to do with the LED lights. Now, it is turned on. You can drive it slow, you can drive it fast. Now, check out when you turn the wheel, the tires turn in the same proportion, and look at that. Turn signals! That's so cool. And then you drive it around. And then from the transmitter, using this mode switch right there, see the button that says LED? Normally a throttle trim. Press that, and we can control the headlights. We can turn the flashers on. We can power it all down. We got dim lights, we got bright lights, we got the flashers on with the lights. So that's really, really cool. Drive around with the headlights on all the time. Might as well, since it has them. And then when you back up, the taillights come on, which to me is really hokey. When you turn the lights on, my taillights don't work until it goes in reverse. And they're hooked up correctly. There's only one way to hook them up. But they don't work until it comes in reverse, so whatever, it's not that huge of a deal. But yeah, that is cool. And that camper weighs down the suspension just enough. Of course, you could stretch out those springs and get that truck to sit a little better. But in real life, these things sag with those campers in the back unless they put overload springs on them. So that is just ultimate cool. I loved this build. I had so much fun. I'm going to take it outside. It is kind of snowy and crappy today, but we're going to get it outside, see if I can get some footage of it driving around in the grass and messing around on those Cooper mud tires. And I will have pictures of the model at the end of this video. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.